with defensive firearms instruction. And in continuation of our duty belt setup videos, I would like to talk about expandable batons. Before we really get into expandable batons, I'd like to talk a little bit about the history of batons. One of the types of batons that have been around for a very long time is actually the PR24 that was produced by Monadnock. Now, this piece of equipment is very, very good and is still used today by corrections and law enforcement. One of the bigger reasons why law enforcement and security have been getting away from carrying the PR24 is specifically the size and the portation of this on the duty belt. Because it's a little bit larger, because it's a little bit more robust, it tends to be a little bit more difficult to carry on your person on a regular basis. So there's a couple different companies that have come out with a different design of an expandable baton. Namely, we have ASP, which is Armament Systems and Procedures, which is this guy right here. Another company that's actually produced some very good equipment is going to be Monadnock. Both of those companies are very good. They've got really good equipment and are both currently being used by law enforcement and security all over the U.S. So let's talk about the sizes. There are three main sizes of expandable batons. We have 16 inch, we have 21 inch, and then we have 26 inch. Probably the most common is going to be the 21 inch. You know, I definitely like using the 21 inch batons simply because it's easier for me to manipulate that baton in tighter spaces. And it actually puts a lot of really good space with my hand on the actual baton itself. Now, with batons, there are going to be two main finishes that we're going to be aware of. First of all, we've got the chrome batons. I really like chrome batons. You know, I like the visual aspect of having a chrome baton. When I deploy this baton, it gives me the ability to use this as a visual deterrent. They also come in a blued finish. I've definitely used the blued finish on a lot of occasions. One of the things I definitely notice about the blued finish is it is going to show wear a lot more. And if you are working in a cold or damp or wet environment, then it is going to be a little bit more prone to rusting. Now, as far as upgrades on your expandable batons, one of the biggest upgrades that you can possibly do is going to be your end cap. This is a good example of an upgraded end cap for this ASP. The cool thing about this end cap is it has a little bit more girth on this back end. And so if for some reason somebody was fighting you for control of your baton, you would have a little bit more mass back here to hang on to. The other thing that I really kind of like about this is you can use your baton in both the open or closed modes. And so you have a little bit more of an impact area on this end right here. Another design of an end cap would be this guy right here. This one's really good when it comes to strikes. You know, I personally feel like I can wrap my pinky around this back end and really, it fits really, really secure in my hand. And also, yet again, it adds just a little bit more distance and a little bit more of an impact force if I am using this in the closed mode. The next thing I'd like to talk about is going to be scabbards. Now, scabbards are the holster, so to speak, for your baton. Now, there's a couple different types of scabbards that are out there. One of the most popular is this guy right here. This is produced by Bianchi. It is in their Bianchi AccuMold line. And this is the type of scabbard that I would typically use if I am placing my baton behind my gun. The benefit to this is it definitely reduces the amount of space on your duty belt. The downfall to this is you don't have a lot of range of motion. The other type that I really like is produced by ASP, which is this guy right here. The cool thing about this baton, it is side break, and we're going to cover that in a second, but it gives me a full range of motion all the way around, just like that. And so if I sit in a car, I can click it forward to make it a little bit more comfortable. When I get out of the car, I can click it back up into a, you know, position that would afford me the ability to deploy it a little easier. The benefit on both of these scabbards is it does allow you to holster your baton with a baton expanded. I see it as a huge benefit. If you are dealing with a suspect, if you expand your baton, if the situation de-escalates, you are going to want to be able to secure that on your person without having to close the baton and take your eyes off of the suspect while you are closing your baton. So having the ability to collapse it or holster it is definitely going to be a huge benefit. The other thing on the side brakes is this does have a little bit of a slit on the side, and so you would have the ability to basically rip the baton off the side while it's expanded. And it does have this little hole right here, and so it still is going to allow the baton to be holstered without collapsing it. The next thing I'd like to talk about is the placement of our scabbard and our baton on our belt. So there are typically two different locations that we're going to want to have our scabbard on our belt. The first spot I'm going to talk about is behind the gun. Now, generally speaking, if I'm going to put anything behind my gun, I'm going to want to have two belt keepers creating distance between my holster and the scabbard. The reason I'm going to do this is I want to be able to create an amount of distance if I have a retention holster. So if I have my baton that is on my duty belt, just like this, if for some reason my baton and scabbard get close enough to my gun, it may restrict my ability to pull my gun out of the holster, which would be a bad thing. The belt keepers, these are not very expensive. These also are through Bianchi. You know, they would go on. The belt keepers typically connect your outer belt to your inner belt. Now, if I'm using this as a spacer, I'm typically just going to want to circle this around the belt, you know, on its own. The other place that we're going to carry it is in kind of a cross draw configuration, which is basically to the left, if you are a right-handed shooter, to the left of your magazine pouches. Now, if we're carrying this to the left of your magazine pouches, human nature is to cross draw it. I highly recommend against cross drawing, because if you reach your arm across your body, it doesn't take a lot of force to be able to hold your arm down and restrict your ability to draw your baton out. So I definitely suggest, if you're going to carry your baton on the support side, that you have a rotating scabbard, and so you can draw it with your support hand and then transfer it over to your dominant hand and then expand it from there. One of the things I highly recommend is if you are going to carry an ASP baton, that you be trained and certified in the use of that ASP baton. A lot of the reasons why is because of liability. If you end up using force, i.e. using your baton, and your actions are called under scrutiny, if you are trained in the use of that baton, then in the event of a lawsuit, the proprietor of that curriculum will defend their curriculum. And as long as you are following that curriculum, the proprietor of that curriculum is in essence going to be protecting you. Having said that, we offer ASP expandable baton training on a very regular basis. So feel free to contact us directly or visit us on the web at defensivefirearmsinstruction.org, and we'd love to see you in class.